The Atomic Fifth.
Now, this has got to be one of these most epic Godzilla versus Kong statues that I've ever seen. I don't think this one right here can be topped unless there's a even bigger statue somewhere with an even more epic looking diorama. But this Godzilla versus Kong statue is made by Prime One Studios. Now, we're going to look at this statue here, but I want to look at some of the other things that Prime One Studios has done related to Godzilla versus Kong. Just real quick. Now, this is the axe. This is the axe that they made. It's $999. I think it's actually like $850 on the Prime One Studio website. And I think you can pay it off in like 9 installments of like $85 if that's something that you actually want to do. But this is what it looks like. This would be an absolutely epic piece to own. I think it would actually complement better if you had some of the other dioramas. So if you had this is the Kong diorama. Now look at this. I've always kind of not been a fan of the real fur, only because I think sometimes it looks a little off for some reason. Like, his fur looks a little bit longer than it should be, I feel like. I don't know. It's just the way that I see it. It looks a little bit, but it looks insane. I mean, look at that level of detail. And I don't think that this kind of fur and stuff ages well either. So it looks insane and epic when you get it, but I think after 10 years or so, this stuff kind of starts to wear. Now, this is the back of the statue, and it shows Kong in the Hollow Earth on this one. And this one is awesome, mainly for that factor. It's a really cool way to do a statue. But the one thing I don't like about it, if I can get back to showing the Hollow Earth part on the back of the statue, is that his throne, I don't think, was this high up. I don't think it was on any stairs or anything like that in the movie. And Godzilla's is kind of similar. I think, if anything, it's just more of a display piece to kind of show. See, look how good that looks with the axe right there. It looks insane. But I think it's just more of a piece to show just how epic Kong is and serve sort of as a tribute, I guess, sort of to Kong. Now, we have the Godzilla one over here as well. And then I'm going to show the diorama. Now, the diorama is the whole reason I made this video, but I figured it's worth showing these other statues as well if you haven't seen them, because these are so cool. Look at this one. This one lights up. And what's crazy is the Kong statue is actually way more expensive, even though I think this one has the LED light effect. Let's see. Yeah, LED light up eyes and the spines. So I guess this isn't like, this isn't the Hollow Earth, but this is kind of Godzilla's home or whatever in King of the Monsters. They got destroyed, his little worship temple that he kind of slept in sort of the center of the earth. I guess maybe it was going towards the Hollow Earth. I'm not sure. I have to go back and kind of rewatch that part again. Now, this I don't think was in the movie. I don't think the design looked anything like this. But like I said, this serves sort of as a tribute to Godzilla. And these statues here are both really cool. The Godzilla and the Kong statue go perfect together. And obviously, it's meant to, you know, kind of complement each other, because you can kind of have them facing off against each other. And then you have the axe with it too, and then, I mean, then you're really talking about a really cool epic display piece. And then we come over, now this was the whole reason I made this video. I woke up, and this was one of the first things I saw this morning, and I'm just taken back by it. Look at how insane this statue looks. So, look at that. This is the entire diorama. And I'm over on the Prime One Studio website. It's $5,699. You can pay in up to 14 installments of $366.36 a month. But look at this. This is the reveal video for the Prime One Studios statue. Now, I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to watch this whole thing, because I've already watched it, and it's 3 minutes long. And it kind of goes over the same pieces again and again and again. But when we go towards the end here, you can see the full diorama. Look at this. You can see just how epic and insane this diorama looks. I mean, the LED light up features on Godzilla, on Kong's axe. Look how that light shines on Kong's face. I'll post this link if you want to watch the whole video. Like I said, I watched it, and it just kind of gets to drag on just a little bit, but this statue is so amazing. It's a little bit out of my budget for now, but at some point in my life, I will get to a point where I can afford something like this. Yeah, and then I didn't notice this part, the product specs. So the statue is 24 inches tall, the LED illuminated Godzilla eyes and mouth, Godzilla dorsal fins featuring the power-up sequence, LED illuminated buildings, LED illuminated fire and explosions, one Godzilla vs. Kong themed Hong Kong base featuring helicopters. Now, it says prototype sample shown, product details could be subject to change without further notice. Obviously, that's all just disclaimers, and that's not really going to happen. They're not just going to change any really major pieces of the statue, I don't think. The statue size on Kong is 24 inches tall. How big was Godzilla? 27? No, 24. Okay. But Kong still looks a tiny bit smaller. LED illuminated buildings, LED illuminated fire and explosions, and one Hong Kong themed Godzilla vs. Kong base featuring a helicopter and damaged vehicles. This just looks so cool. You guys comment down below. Let me know what you think about this. This is the product specs for the entire diorama. 31 inches tall, 56 inches wide, 26 inches deep. Oh my gosh, man. This thing is a beast. Like I said, it would almost have to be the centerpiece of a room. Maybe a Godzilla man cave or something like that. I don't know. But yeah, you guys comment down below. Let me know what you think about it. That's all I have for today. I just wanted to post this diorama on my channel and kind of post my reaction to it, because this thing, I'm such a sucker for all the Godzilla versus Kong figures and the statues and stuff like that. But these higher end statues have always been something that I've only ever been able to kind of look at and wish I could have. But one day, hopefully, I will be able to buy one of these epic pieces. But all right, guys, that's all I have for today. So as always, if you're new here, be sure to like the video. That helps out the YouTube algorithm. Consider subscribing as well. I post all kinds of nerdy content all the time, especially relating to the MonsterVerse, but also Marvel and DC and a little bit of Star Wars and pretty much anything I'm passionate about related to comics and pop culture and all that stuff. So with all that being said, until the next video, be safe and stay well. Bye-bye.
I failed my mission, and now I'm working with the enemy. And I can't even get that right.